And last question, Chetta, then we'll go into the questions that we are receiving now. So I just want both of you to comment on this, you know, mentality of contraceptive that we have today in our society. Like, even a lot of Christians, you know, practice contraception in their marriage. So in this movie, it says contraceptive failure is equal to accidental pregnancy. I mean, as Christians, we do not believe that any pregnancy is accidental. It's a gift from God. So God does not produce accidents, right? So could you talk a little bit about contraception and how pregnancy is a gift from God?
First of all, you know, contraception is not allowed in Catholic Christianity, especially Catholic Church.
Yes, yes.
Because the purpose of marriage is, as I told you, is procreation. We are not reproducing. Okay, animals reproduce. The word we use in human beings is procreation. We are creating something which is in the image of God. We are co-workers with God.
Yes.
Okay, that is the purpose for which God has implemented marriage. Okay, that is the purpose for all marriage. So once you take away life from sex, okay, the purpose of sex, sex is not an indoor game between man and woman. It is self-giving. You give yourself, your soul, body, mind, and soul, and spirit to another person. That is called sex, and that is love, giving yourself to another person. So when you, that is called love. When there is love, love should have four aspects. Then it should become love. Otherwise, it is only lust. So that when you speak about love, you should look at God for love, because God is the source of love, and He is love.
He is love.
So only from Him we can, whom we can define lovers. Otherwise, love can be misunderstood. Okay, it's the wrong definition can come to love. That is what happens to love in this world. So the first aspect of love is it should be free. There should be freedom. Okay, God loves us without any condition and any limits. He gives us a freedom even to kill Him. Okay, that is how He loves us. So that freedom should be there. Then only it should be this love. Then the second one is total giving.
Yes,
God gave us His blood, body, soul, and spirit, everything. That is how He loved us. He never kept anything back. Okay. So when you give complete love, you're loving somebody, you should give totally everything.
Yes.
And you cannot spare your sperm from giving to your wife. Okay. That is not love. Okay. When you use contraception, that's why church teaches it is not love. Okay. It is only pleasure and lust.
Yes.
So it is selfish activity. The third one is faithfulness. You should be faithful even if your wife is not faithful or partner is not faithful. You should be faithful. That is how God loves us. We are always unfaithful to God, but God is faithful and He forgives and loves. And the fourth aspect of love is when you love somebody, there should be life. When God loved us, we received the Holy Spirit. We got divine life. So if any of these four elements is missing in a marriage, it is not love. Okay. It is something else. So that is why the church teaches us that there shouldn't be any contraception. So then contraception is when you remove contraception out of marriage, then any time. See, when a sperm and ovum is clubbed together, that's how life has been formed.
Yes.
Every time a sperm and ovum comes together, God is waiting to
create life.
See, as He created the soul in Adam, God is waiting to implant the soul, the spirit into that body. Okay. So at that time, this is what God's plan about life. So there we cannot become a hindrance and say that, no, I don't want life there. I just want pressure. So that is one problem. The second aspect is that, see, we are always, when we love each other, we should always expect life. So once you take away life from that, then we can call it love. So life can come anytime, and it is only God can decide when a child should be born. That is what God gives the spirit. Okay. And when God gives a spirit, we cannot bring forth a child. If a man and woman decides, okay, tomorrow or next month we can bring forth, it is not possible. That is why so many couples don't have children.
Yes.
Because when you take it medically, they are fit for everything, but they don't have children. We don't know why. Because we know Life comes from heaven.
Mm.
So only if God gives, we can receive it.
Mm.
So there is nothing called accidental, or when life comes, we need to know whether it is you planned it or not. It is God's plan.
Mm.
So, okay, you have to receive. That's the way you should end. Every other statement is wrong.
Yeah.
So it is nothing called accidental. This for human beings, it is accident. For God, everything happens according to His plan.
Hi. Thank you for watching the Song on Fire YouTube channel. Please subscribe to the channel for more Catholic interviews, music, and lifestyle videos. If you feel inspired, please click on the Patreon link to contribute and support to the Song on Fire Catholic Ministries. God bless.